Good afternoon. I'm Shawki Abdallah. I'm the acting president of the University of New Mexico, and it's my pleasure to welcome you to the Pit. The history of basketball between NMSU and UNM goes way back. It goes to 1904, actually, before we became a state, before New Mexico became a state. And throughout that, we've had amazing rivalries and amazing successes, both places. Paul Weir, our new coach, has been a New Mexico resident for 11 years. So one of the benefits of that is we don't have to explain to him the benefits of green or red, or ask him which one. What does he like? How does he like his chili? And New Mexico State under Paul has had enjoyed very good success. In fact, they've been to the NCAA tournament 6 out of the last 8 years, and he's been a winner every place he's been, from New Mexico State, Iowa, Northwestern State. So we'd like to welcome here to UNM. We would like to welcome him, his beautiful family, and his wife Alma, and his little son. Where is Theodore? He was here, and he was wearing a Lobo T-shirt. So that's great start. So at this time, I'd like to introduce our Vice President of Athletics, Paul Krebs, who will welcome our coach. Thank you.
Thanks, Chowkey. I want to thank everybody for being here. Also want to recognize a couple members of our athletic department staff who were involved in the search process. And I apologize, I hope I don't omit anybody, but Brad Hutchins, Janice Ruggiero, Ed Manzanares, Chelsea Chamberlain, Frank Mercogliano, and Cara Dana were all very instrumental in some way or other with this process that led to the hiring of Coach Weir. It was 11 days ago, it may seem a lot longer than that, but it was actually 11 days ago that we made a change with Coach Neal. And actually, it was a week ago today where we had a press conference with the media talking about the search. So I think in athletic department and in college athletics, I would argue that this was a relatively quick process, but a thorough process. You know, I saw some folks who described the process a little bit of a roller coaster. I think from an internal perspective, it was relatively smooth. We had a small committee. We engaged in a lot of dialogue. And while there was a lot of speculation out in the media, we ended up where we needed to be. The process allowed us to get to the right place, which was to find the best individual, the best coach at this time for the University of New Mexico. So I feel good that the process worked. Some of the criteria that we laid out before, and I'll walk through again, you know, obviously you want to hire somebody who's got great basketball skills, who's a great basketball mind. I think when you look at Coach Weir, and you talk to people in and around the state, people have observed him closely at New Mexico State as well as others. I think there are a couple of other things that really stand out. One, a tireless work ethic, very engaged in the community. If you watch his teams play, and I had the luxury of my role on the NCAA committee, basketball committee this past year, one of the conferences that I was assigned to was the WAC, and so I probably live or on video probably watched 7 or 8 New Mexico State games. What I saw, and I'm certainly not a coach, but what I saw was a team that played hard, a team that played really good defense, a team that gave great effort every night, and very strong rebounding. One of the things that really impressed me about Coach Weir in the interview process, and it was a very impressive process, a very impressive interview, really a lot of conversation about leadership and developing a team, a sense of unity and leadership. Has a focus on analytics, which, as we all know, in all of our businesses, that's where the world's headed. He knows New Mexico, he knows our team, he knows the Mountain West, and strong, certainly given his academic record, strong with academics and the development of his team. We did talk about head coaching experience. I would admit, I'd be the first to admit that while Paul's only been a head coach for 1 year, you look at what he accomplished in that 1 year, I think the committee felt it was very impressive. Economics, and I know that'll be a question that'll come up, economics is are a factor in every decision, whether it's at the university, in any business we're in, they are a factor. What I can tell you is that we offered the same financial package to all the candidates with collegiate head coaching experience. So I'll give you a couple other business points and then let the star of the show come up and talk. We're still working on a contract. We do have a letter of agreement in place. The starting salary for Coach Weir in year one is $625,000. We are not involved in any buyout at New Mexico State. Any issue with a buyout between Coach Weir and New Mexico State is between them. We have no financial obligation for that. I feel good that we got the best candidate through this process. Coach Weir rose to the top. In my view, the process worked, and I'm excited to introduce our new basketball coach and really look forward to watching Coach Weir build and develop this program and make the Lobo basketball family very proud. So let me introduce to you Coach Paul Weir. We started a tradition about a red jacket. I'm going to let Coach Weir make a few comments about that, but here's the ceremonial red cherry blazer.
Thank you very much. Yeah, I can put it right here again. Yeah, they wanted me to wear the red blazer. I told them I hadn't earned it yet. That's for me to do now. I got to find a way to win some games. Sorry, I made some notes. I just want to put these here. Hasn't been a ton of prep time for today, and I like to do prep, but this is obviously an amazing opportunity for me, for my family, my own kind of professional competencies and stimulation. You know, I was at New Mexico State for 10 years, poured my heart and soul into the place. It was very, very successful. Started my family there, got degrees there, and it would have taken a lot for me to leave, and this was that opportunity. It was just simply too good to pass up for a lot of levels. And I just had to come to New Mexico. I'm extremely thankful to be here. There's a number of people I need to thank. It obviously starts with Paul Krebs, who ran the search and the committee, the entire committee and him, I believe, vetted a lot of candidates. And I feel very confident that I won that. When I interviewed for my last job at State, I went through the exact same process. I went up against other candidates, and I felt I was the best one, and they did too. And I take comfort in knowing to go through that process and really to come out on top and kind of feel as though you're someone's first choice. So I take a lot of kind of solace in that, and I thank them for giving me this opportunity. There's going to be a lot of questions about me. I totally get it. I was a one-year head coach. I'm coming from New Mexico State. I'm a little bit unknown, and I'm well aware of what I'm stepping into. The Greek philosopher Atticus once said, every doubter is a dreamer with a broken heart. And I think there's some broken hearts around here that it's my job to go out and pick up. And that's all I'm going to do from now on. It could be our players. It could be fans. It could be administrators. It could be supporters. Just anyone around the community that might be questioning what's going on with Lobo basketball, I'm going to do everything in my power to win them over. Our team is going to play really, really hard. I know that sounds cliche. I know that sounds kind of boring, but that's really what I pride myself on, is us just being the hardest working team we can possibly be. We're not going to look for excuses. We're not going to be flashy. We're just going to play really hard and really fast. At New Mexico State, that style of play was Neil McCarthy, and here it's probably Storm and Norman. I think we all look back to those eras of basketball and culture and tradition and honor that we all kind of yearn for, and it's my job to try and bring that back. I'm a builder. I'm a communicator. I really want to have great relationships with our players. I met with them this morning. Hopefully going to build really close relationships with them. I know there's a lot of expectations, or I should say lack of expectations, about the team this coming season, and we're going to conquer every single one of them. If people want to doubt us, that's fine. But as a group, collectively, we're going to come together, and we're going to overcome all those odds. My wife Alma's right here. She's coming with me, thankfully. And I have a two-year-old running around here somewhere. His name's Theodore, and he's a mess. But But this is an amazing place, and it would have taken a lot for me to leave. There's people back in New Mexico State that are very disappointed in me, probably will never forgive me, but just being here right now, I know this was the right decision. I'm extremely thankful for the opportunity, and I really can't wait to get to work. We've got some recruits in this weekend and just get going in practice, and it's full steam ahead. I really don't know any other way, and I'm just really grateful to be a part of the Lobo family. For some of you that think I'm a bit of an outsider, I hope you welcome me with open arms, and for every single one of you, just please come to the games. For us to build this program, we've got to get the pit rocking again and get that thing full, and that's my goal here going forward. So, students, I'm coming for you. The rest of Lobo Nation, I'm coming for you. And the players, I hope you guys believe in me and we can start to build something together. So thank you guys all very much.
There we go. At this time, we're going to open it up for questions from the media. I believe Coach Weir knows most of you guys, but just in case, say your name just to be safe. We'll start right here with Van.
Coach Weir, right out the gate, is this strange for you as far as being with the Aggies and then now you're Lobo?
Yeah, when I interviewed, I told the committee, I think I got called about, I don't know what it was, 4 or 5 o'clock. And for the first 5 or 6 hours, it's probably the way it a lot of people have received it, a little like, wow, this is a little unusual. You know, this is a little strange, maybe skeptical, maybe apprehension, fear, you know, whatever it may be. But by about 10 or 11 o'clock, I was just like, no, wow. I mean, this is Lobo basketball. And by the time I got into that, you know, interview the following day, I was full steam ahead. And so I get at first even the reaction. I think it's natural because I even had it. But I think in time, as you really think about it and you process the situation, both mine, you know, back at State and the one here, to me it was just an opportunity of a lifetime and just one I just couldn't pass up. I get, you know, that there are feelings hurt, and for that I apologize. I'm sorry to those people, but this was just too good of an opportunity for me.
Coach, Will Weber from the Santa Fe New Mexican. The 4 players that announced they were transferring, have you had any contact with them, and what's your point of attack and maybe possibly getting these guys back?
Yeah, I mean, I just met with the team now. I think there were a couple players that had some other kind of things going on, be it academics, that weren't there. I really, every single member of this organization, players, staff, support staff, I want to sit down with, get to know. I'm a big believer in win-win relationships. And I think they have to believe in me and I have to believe in them. And that's a road that we're going to start to go down individually, up and down the entire organization, whether it's just players or staff members. And, you know, I just spoke to them now a lot about my vision and what I kind of see for them and what I see for our team. And if they want to be a part of that, I want every single one of them. If for whatever reason they have a different vision that aligns with something else, then, you know, it might not be a healthy marriage for either of us.